Hey there everyone, this is Jake James Lugo. Welcome to the channel and welcome to this new unboxing and impressions video. We're going to be taking a look at the World of the Witcher video game compendium from Dark Horse Comics, or Dark Horse I should say, because it's not necessarily a comic, but you guys know I love video game books or video game related hardcover books or coffee table books, so I just got a couple of them. I also just shot my one for God of War Lores and Legends, and now I get to talk about this one. You all know, if you've seen my review of The Witcher 3, you know I love The Witcher. The Witcher is dope. The Witcher is awesome, so it was only natural that I finally got to this at some point. But as I'm opening up this bad boy, make sure you guys leave a like on this video, comment down below with your thoughts about the book or The Witcher in general if you guys want to, and don't forget to subscribe to the channel too. So anyway, The World of the Witcher, a deep dive into the world of the monsters, But yeah, this is supposed to be about everything involving The Witcher. I hope it's covering Witcher 1, 2, and 3, the games, and maybe some of the stuff from the books, or everything together in general. So anyway, let's unwrap this bad boy. You know, my favorite game obviously is The Witcher 3 out of the entire series. I never really got to play Witcher 1 and 2, but I always said that CD Projekt Red somehow needs to remaster those games and give it the gameplay systems, or just the combat and some of the other systems from Witcher 3, so people could experience those stories, because it would sell gangbusters. It would be so good. I'm just saying, right? But anyway, here's the book. Feels good, hardcover book. Doesn't look very meaty compared to other coffee table books we've looked at in the past, but this does look pretty darn nice. It's got a nice glare to it, a nice sheen, okay? It's a lot of stuff, so hold on, what is it saying here? And those that hunt them as Geralt's most trusted companions guide you on a fascinating tour of the world of The Witcher, collecting in-depth knowledge of breathtaking locales, the deadly beasts that inhabit them, and the lethal weapons used to put them down. Okay, so that's interesting. But anyway, it's got the nice CD Projekt Red logo on there. This is good CD Projekt Red. Okay, so let's open this bad boy up, see what's inside. Got that nice Witcher medallion, or Witcher, School of the Wolf. It's pretty freaking sweet. Then we got that nice splash page of Geralt, and I think, oh no, it's just some random soldier there. I was going to say it's Vesemir, but it's not. Okay, so we got intro, we got the world and its inhabitants, we got the witchers themselves, magic and religions of the continent, the beasts of the Northern Kingdoms, and the story of Geralt of Rivia. So I'm guessing that's just like a summary of like what happens in the books. Because remember, the games take place after the books, okay? All the books happen, but then the first Witcher game happens right after the last book or the last short story. Okay, so, dear reader, the tome you hold in your hand is a compilation of a multitude of notes and drafts, both by those authored by myself and those, etc. So again, I'm not going to read the full thing, but this is Dandelion, okay? Anybody that doesn't know, Dandelion is like Geralt's, like, you know, his bard, or his, like, his boy, his, you know, dude that sings. It's the same person as, that appeared in the Netflix series, but they just don't call him Dandelion. So the world and its inhabitants. We're going to get some really cool imagery. Look at this stuff. Let me try to fix the camera here so you guys could see it in its full glory. This looks really freaking sweet. Yeah, the world and its history, which, again, I'm not going to read all of it now, but we're just looking at stuff. You can see, what is that? Is that a maiden? Some random maiden? Yeah, it just looks like some random maiden in there. And then these landscapes, the Northern Kingdoms. All this stuff looks sweet, man. I love the full-color photos, you know, all put together really nicely, real organized. Nilfgaard, look at that. Look at that imagery, man. Well, this, man, this is so freaking dope. Okay. Of course, I'm pretty sure this is gonna have a lot of deep cut stuff related to The Witcher, and I think is that the king? Because I can't tell whether that's who is that. Okay, no, that's just some random person. I thought that was like one of the main characters. But anyway, the geography, it talks about this stuff, you know, the settings. I love how The Witcher game, specifically The Witcher 3, everything is such a wide open space. It's so detailed, but it also runs pretty darn smoothly. Like, look at this mid-page spread. It looks so good, man. Okay, let's keep going here. I'm just gonna, like, you know, fix the camera, make sure you guys can see it clearly. Human lands, we got like the places of which you go visit, Corvir, the Great Kingdoms, Redania, Kaidwan, etc., etc., etc. Whole bunch of places. Look at all the character designs, you know, different clothing for different stuff. Doesn't that look like freaking Odin from the MCU? I mean, look at that, for real. Hold on. Stop the press. Look at that. That freaking looks like Odin from the MCU. I'm just saying, let me know in the comment section if you think that he was probably used as like the basis for that character design, because I'm just saying it's way too similar. I'm not complaining though, but I'm just noticing it, which is funny. But anyway, let's keep going. The Lesser Kingdoms. Let's get to some more stuff. I want to get to the Witcher stuff. I want to get to some more Witcher stuff specifically, okay? Because we got too much of the kingdoms in here that, at least for the sake of this video, I'm going to look through all this stuff. I can't wait. It'd be so freaking cool. Okay, the witches. The witches. There goes a nice, cool, it's a little hard to see that little middle section there of Geralt fighting, I guess, some sort of like mermaid or some sort of like, you know, a sea creature. Talks about no man has ever known more about witches than Vesemir, who practiced the craft both in its glory days and through the time of its greatest trials and decline. That's true, because Vesemir is the oldest witcher around. So we got all the different witchers, which are the school of the wolf. There goes Vesemir right there, I believe. Okay. And then this one, the unexpected child, which I guess, is this supposed to be Geralt? No, I don't think so. Could be wrong. No, this is Geralt. Law of surprise, a particular magical form. Well, yeah, okay. So yeah, that is Geralt. It's just a cool rendition of him. It's pretty sweet. Okay, and there goes some more versions of him. I'm guessing this is from Witcher 1 and 2, because he looks obviously a lot younger here. Some of this design, I don't know whether it's specifically from Witcher 1 or Witcher 2. This is definitely Witcher 3. This looks like Geralt from Witcher 3. We have a whole bunch of other stuff around here, which is cool. Mutations in the Trial of the Grasses, which they talk about all this stuff. The Purge. A lot of history here with the Witchers. Hey, Witcher's creators, which, oh man, I can't wait to read all this stuff. It's going to be so sweet. And I definitely want to get a medallion of the Witcher symbol, the School of the Wolf. I want to actually get a medallion, a Witcher medallion, because they look freaking sweet to me. Hey, look at this. Look at these rendered and, like, you know, illustrations, man. They look so dope. They look so freaking dope, man. Kaer Morhen, of course, which is where Geralt and Vesemir hang out and they just chill. Now, the Witcher abilities and training talks about all this stuff. Look at this, man. Looks sweet. Monster lore, the gauntlet, Witcher secrets, a lot of stuff. The weapons, that's what I like to see. The Witcher swords. So you got the Iron Blade and the Silver Blades. All this stuff, the code, the medallion they talk about. Sweet. This is going to be good, man. Let's get some more of this stuff. And look at this spread here. This is awesome. This is freaking awesome, man. The magic and religions of the concept. So now I'm going to go a little bit faster because I know I'm kind of like, you know, really just like going out of my way. Okay, so we're starting to get to some of the mages. We're going to get into a lot of this, yo. This is so good. Let me just skim through it. Okay, hopefully I can show stuff. Okay, yeah, I can still show stuff for YouTube because you know how it gets in here. It was just freaking sweet, man. A lot of stuff. Look at this. This is so cool. So cool stuff. Okay, but anyway, going in here. Ah, we can't show any more of that. That looks bad. Okay, we got monsters, necrophages. This is a lot of this stuff. A lot of these renders, a lot of this concept art. Look at this dragon here, or this wyvern. This looks sweet. A lot of this stuff looks sweet. Insectoids. So much from this actual stuff. And then here's the story of Geralt of Rivia. I'm guessing it's going to have a recap of his entire story, the beginnings of a beautiful friendship. Yeah, this is, again, Witcher 1, I believe. Does this say? No, it doesn't say which game, but it looks like that's from Witcher 1. And then this looks like it's from Witcher 3. It's a lot of stuff. The Feast in Sintra. Yeah, it talks about all this stuff. So I'm guessing like they get into the things about the books. Oh man, there's a lot in here. Wow, look at that. It's Ciri. This was a cool thing of Ciri before though, by the way. Let's go back to that. Look at that cool render of Ciri. That illustration. Because it doesn't look like a 3D model. It looks like just a straight up like, you know, 2D like or 3D drawn image of her. She's really cool. Where is that? The Fate of Cirilla. The Princess of Sintra. Oh man, look at that. Look at this. They get through all this stuff and look at even some of the, like, you know, 2D illustrations from some of the previous games. That's pretty cool. I love this. This is a cool book. I can't wait to really deep dive. Look at this. This is like poster or like giant wall hanging material. This looks awesome. Okay. And then there goes a nice cool, one shot Geralt with everybody. And then this was straight up from Witcher 3. I remember this was the promo from Witcher 3. And he looks dope, man. He looks awesome there. So, yeah. If you couldn't already tell, I dig this book. I love The Witcher. I love The Witcher World. Hey, look. They even got an adventure game. Maybe one day, maybe I should hit up that company and see if they want me to actually do an unboxing of something like that. That'd be kind of cool. But, yeah, man. So, there goes all the artists, everybody else, CD Projekt Red, all the stuff, ads. This is a dope book. If you're a fan of The Witcher, if you just got into the series, you know, either through the game for Witcher 3, or if you've watched the Netflix series The Witcher with Henry Cavill, which is dope, by the way, you have to watch it. Definitely check out this book. It has a ton of stuff in here, it seems like. I can't wait to read more of it. This is freaking dope. Gets the seal of approval by me. So, anyway, that's going to do it for this unboxing and impressions video of the World of The Witcher video game compendium from Dark Horse. Let me know what's up in the comments section down below. Tell me some of your thoughts about The Witcher. If you like this book, if you're going to pick it up yourself, let me know about that stuff. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel, leave a like on this video, and I will talk to all of you again very soon. Peace out, and stay epic, everybody. Thanks so much for checking out this video, everybody. I really appreciate your time and your support. Make sure you guys subscribe to the channel when you can. Don't forget to leave me a like on this video and comment down below. And also, don't forget to check out my Patreon page. I got a lot of great content that I know you're gonna love. There's links down below in the description box. I hope you guys have a chill day. Peace out and stay epic, everybody.